Hello, I hope you're doing fantastic. In this series, we've been talking about using the Arduino millis function to create timed events. Like maybe every 3 seconds you want a servo to move, or maybe every minute you want to send a status update to a web server. Whatever it may be, you want something to occur at a timed interval. Now, if you haven't seen the previous lessons in this series, I highly recommend that after this lesson, you go back and check them out. I think you're going to find them very helpful. Now, in this lesson, we are going to cover creating multiple timed events using the Arduino millis function. Specifically, in this lesson, we are going to map out a program that will execute two independent timed events. We'll code from scratch a program that reads and displays two sensor values at different intervals. And finally, we'll drink Kool-Aid and watch the sun go down. Every good program has an even better algorithm to go along with it. So before we start typing away at the Arduino IDE, first I want to write out our plan of action. This is kind of like what we're trying to accomplish. Okay, I've got two sensors. One is a light dependent resistor, or LDR, and the other is a temperature sensor. And what I want to do is I want to read these values and I want to display them to the serial monitor window on my computer. But I don't want to do it all the time. I want to have it happen at two separate intervals. I want my light dependent resistor to read and display every second, and I want my temperature sensor to read and display every 5 seconds. So I've got two separate events. So I'm just going to lay it out like event one, that happens every second. I want to read my LDR, and then I want to display the LDR value. And then event two, this is going to happen every 5 seconds. I want to read a temperature sensor and then display that temperature sensor. And I'm going to display them to the serial monitor window on the Arduino. Okay, so this is kind of the plan of action. And, you know, looking at this, I figure, you know, we could use the Arduino millis function to set up the timing for these events. I could use analog read to read the LDR and the temperature sensor values. And then we could use the serial library to display those values to the serial monitor window on our computer. When you're creating a program that has repetitive timed events, it also doesn't hurt to kind of lay out the timing of the events on a piece of paper. If we lay this out on a timeline, we can see that we have two events that overlap every 5 seconds. Luckily for us, we are using the millis function as opposed to trying to make this work with the Arduino delay function. So this should definitely be achievable. Now in this lesson, we are focusing on demonstrating how to code timed events with Arduino. So I'm not going to go into setting up the LDR and temperature sensor circuits. So just assume that I have them wired up. But if you're wondering how to do that, definitely check out the programmingelectronics.com website for lessons on setting up different circuits. All right, so let's go ahead and jump into the Arduino IDE and start coding this thing from scratch. So here we are in the Arduino IDE, and I'm going to start by just making myself a little to-do list in comments. So let me do that. Okay, so I've got a little to-do list written out here. I'm just going to kind of work through them. I won't hold myself tight to these, but I just thought I'd give it a shot. Might help me kind of work through the program. The first thing I'm going to do is set up some pins for where I've got my sensors attached. So let me do that. Okay, so I've got two constants, and I made these constants because they're not going to change. These sensors are always going to be at these pins, and I used analog pin A2 and analog pin A4 for the LDR and temp sensor, respectively. So that's pretty straightforward. I've got my circuit set up there. Actually, I'm using the kit on a shield to kind of work through this program. And now what I'm going to do is set up variables for the timed events. So I'll do that now. All right, so I have created two constants and two variables. The two constants are the event times. This is like the interval at which I want each of these events to happen. Like I mentioned, I want to read and display the light dependent resistor value every 1000 milliseconds. I want to read and display the temperature sensor every 5000 milliseconds or every 5 seconds. So I've got those set up. Those intervals aren't going to change, so I made them constants. Oh, but you know what? I need to make them unsigned too. Also. Let me do that. Okay, the variables I've created, I've named previous time one and previous time two. They're both unsigned longs. The reason I'm using this unsigned long data type is because the value from millis gets really big, and I want to make sure that I've got enough storage in that variable type, in that variable data type, to hold that really big number. So these previous time variables allow us to help track the time as these events occur. And if any of this is looking foreign to you, make sure to check out the previous lessons, and some of this code has already been explained. All right, so I'm going to move on to the setup, and I'm going to set up serial communication. I'll do that now. All right, I've used the begin function from the serial library, and I initiate serial communication using the serial begin function. I'm using 9600 as a baud rate. Pretty standard stuff there. So now I'm down in the loop, and what I want to do in the loop, and I want to do it frequently, is I want to update the current time. So I'm going to create a current time variable, and it's going to constantly get updated with the millis function. So I'm going to do that now. So I've created a variable named current time, and I set it equal to the return value of millis. So current time is going to hold a snapshot of the value millis has counted up to that point. And every time through the loop, we're going to be updating it. And again, it's an unsigned long because it's going to hold a really big number. And so I want to make sure that the current time variable has space to hold that really big number. All right, now I'm going to set up the event timing for the first event. Let me do that. Okay, so I have set up the timing for my first event. So the key to this event timing is this first if statement condition. And what we're doing is we're comparing the difference between the current time and the previous time with our event interval. So you can think of event time one as just 1000 because it's a constant, it's never going to change. And what we're doing is we're looking at the current time, which is always updating, and we're seeing how much further it is from the previous time that the event happened. In the previous time, this previous time one, it only gets updated every time the event happens. So it kind of lags behind the current time. So as that first calculation increases, eventually it's going to exceed that event time interval. So once this condition becomes true, then we run our event code. We print to the serial monitor, hey, the LDR is, and then what we do is an analog read. So analog read, we're looking at the light dependent resistor pin that we had declared previously. So we get that reading and we print it out to the serial monitor window. So this is the event code. This is what we actually want to have happen. Now down here, this is also a very important statement. This is how we are updating our previous time so that in another 1000 milliseconds, we can get this code to run again. So we're setting the previous time equal to the current time. So we're nudging this value to kind of catch up with the current time. So if this first line of code is a little confusing to you, I get it. You know, it is kind of confusing the first time around. I think if you just kind of run some numbers through this, watch some of the previous lessons, you'll start to get how pretty straightforward this is. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I am going to run this and I'm going to upload it just to make sure everything seems to be working okay so far. Okay, so it looks about every second I'm getting this reading from my light dependent resistor. I'll put my hand over. Okay, everything looks like it's working appropriately. So that's cool. I have one timed event. Well, now I want to add another timed event. How am I going to do that? Well, all I'm going to do is repeat this exact same thing, but I'm going to have different code on the inside, and I'm going to use the variables that I'd set up for that second timed event. So I'll do that now. All right, well, you can see that I pretty much just did the exact same thing over again. I just used different variables this time. I used the event2 variables as opposed to the event1 variables. I've uploaded the sketch, I've opened the serial monitor, and we can see that, hey, this is pretty sweet. I'm getting my 5 light-dependent resistor readings, and then I'm also getting my temperature sensor reading. And the events are happening at the time I wanted them to be. So I've got 2 independent, repetitive events working here right in this program. And it wasn't that painful to write this out. I think the toughest part is just wrapping your head around that if statement condition. Once you can nail that down and understand the comparison that's happening, you know, we've got this interval on the right, that's how often we want something to happen. And then we're just comparing the current time, the time that has elapsed, and the previous time, how long has it been since the last event? You know, and those two values are both getting updated. Once you can wrap your head around that, and it does take a while, you know, you might not fully get it after this lesson. I understand that completely. I would recommend, you know, writing this out yourself once. You may maybe try turning an LED on and off or some events, just some really basic program, just so you can drive this home. Okay, well, let's just do a quick review of what we did in this lesson. First, we mapped out what we were doing just by writing out our algorithm before we actually get into the code. Then we went into the Arduino IDE, and from scratch, we wrote a program that created 2 separate timed events. Well, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Again, there's a whole series on using this millis function. Definitely check out the other videos in the series. I look forward to seeing you next time. Have a great day. Bye.